Introducing a junior from Dallas, Texas, Momoko Iwai. A freshman from Hudson, Wisconsin, Madison Reidenbach. A sophomore from Stuart, Florida, Ava Mavanta. A senior from Sanford, Florida, Abby Thompson. A freshman from Woodinville, Washington, Amanda Hargraves. A freshman from Fort Mill, South Carolina, Madison Ulrich. A freshman from Austin, Texas, Ashley Gallen. A senior from Frisco, Texas, Bella Mavanta. A sophomore from Cincinnati, Ohio, Mila Brush. A sophomore from Charlotte, North Carolina, Kylie Rorick. A senior from Weddington, North Carolina, a junior from Lone Tree, Colorado, Mia Hebe. A sophomore from New York City, New York, Cecilia Cooley. In the kitchen. A senior from Parker, Colorado, Riley Mundell. And a senior from Gilbertsville, Pennsylvania, Jessica Hutchinson. Denver is led by the Joyous Burns head women's gymnastics coach, Melissa Kutcher-Reinhardt, associate head coach, Lena Skaveka, and assistant coaches, Stephen Hood and Mia Sundstrom. The director of operations is Marissa Sodden. The meet director is Alex Bala. You met them earlier, our hype crew, who will be bringing the energy all night long, Tom and Taylor. At this time, we ask that you please rise, remove your hats, and turn your attention to the flag for the singing of our national anthem, performed today by Liv Bevins.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight? Broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight. O'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting.
Welcome to Magnus Arena here on the campus of the University of Denver for a great meet between the University of Denver Pioneers, the Iowa State Cyclones, and the Southeast Missouri Red Hawks. My name is Marcy Jenkins. I'm here with you today. We'll be showing you all three events at the same time. We're finishing our four-minute touch warm-up right now. This will be a great competition. University of Denver coming off of a 198 at home last week, their highest score so far this season. Southeast Missouri and Iowa State both coming off of not their highest meets last week, so they'll definitely want to improve on those scores. Pioneers are currently ranked 9th in the nation. Iowa State is 22nd. We have a great crowd here in Magnus Arena on this sunny but cold winter day ahead of the Super Bowl. Everyone taking the opportunity to be a part of this great gymnastics, which will finish up right before the Super Bowl starts. The University of Denver will start on vault, Iowa State will start on bars, and Southeast Missouri will start on beam. There's a picture of the Pioneer squad getting ready to start their vaulting rotation. They've got a team of really strong seniors carrying that team, but some amazing freshmen as well. We're going to start off on vault with Mila Brush, sophomore from the University of Denver. She'll be doing her Yurchenko full, starting out of a 9.95 start value. Beautiful vault, and that was a great landing. Just beautiful position in the air. Iowa State on bars is Ella Schell. Beautiful Pike Jaeger. And on beam is Anna Choden. Nice handstand right before that giant pull right on top of the bar. And that was a great start for Iowa State on bars. Just a slight little move on the dismount. But a really, really nice routine. Next up on vault for the Pioneers will be Madison Reidenbach, freshman. Hitchcock to front tosh combination on beam. A nice high Yurchenko full. She's been working on a 1.5 and we'll put that into the lineup, but that was a great vault for the Pioneers and a nice finish on beam for Southeast Missouri in their first competitor in this rotation. Next up on bars for Iowa State will be Logan Bassel. High score so far on bars for Iowa State this season has been a 49.250. Handstand. Beautiful straddle, Jaeger. A little short on that handstand. And slightly short on that handstand as well, so it'll be a little bit of a deduction from the judges. A little over on the giant pull, but another solid routine for them on bars. Little deductions here and there. Next up on vault for the Pioneers is Madison Ulrich. She'll be doing a 10-0 start value vault. It's front handspring front pike with a half. Let's see if she can stick the landing. And that was probably the best I've seen her do it so far. Great landing for Madison. Up on beam for Southeast Missouri is Madison Green. That was a really good save by Madison. Her foot was almost completely off before she took out for that second layout. Just a little bit off on that leap series. Next up on vault for the Pioneers will be Riley Mundell. She'll be our first look at a Yurchenko 1.5, a 10-0 start value. Denver has 4 10-0 start values in their lineup today. Riley had an amazing vault last weekend. Next up on Iowa State on bars is Paige Willis. And a nice Yurchenko 1.5 for Riley, just a hop at the end. At least a tenth of a point deduction there. Nice handstand on bars. And a pretty big hop on the landing, but these routines definitely have a lot of potential. Just little details. I talked to their coach right before Ashley Miles-Grigg, before the meet, and she said, you know, it's been a big transition for them this year with her coming in as the head coach, new assistant coaches, and they're really, really working on the details. The details matter, and they have a whole set of new standards, and this team is just in a, Iowa State squad has done a great job really coming together in this under new leadership and has a ton of potential. Next up on vault for the Pioneers is Rosie Casale. And on beam is Jordan Napolitano. Rosie will be doing a Yurchenko 1.5. Pretty big hop on that landing. Just a little bit of extra power on that vault. Next up on bars is Lauren Thomas. A little short on that first handstand. Nice release move. Back salto. Overall, she's moving very well. Nice handstand right on top of the bar, what the judges are looking for. Let's see if she can stick this dismount. Really fought for that dismount. Had to bend down a little bit, so it'll be a slight deduction, but I love to see that fight on those landings. Next up on vault for the Pioneers is going to be their senior, Jessica Hutchinson. Jessica competed for the Bulgarian national team and has been such a staple for the squad, just cool, calm and collected, and really someone they can count on. And a stuck Yurchenko 1.5. We'll have to see what the judges do with that. That was absolutely gorgeous. She's really been working on form in the air, legs together, legs straight, toes together, toes pointed. I wish we could see that in slow motion, because that was an absolutely perfect vault. Nice series on beam. Back handspring layout, step out. Next up on bars is Hannah Loyum. Little bit of toe separation on that giant half, but beautiful release move. Little over on that as well. And she had to work really hard for that. That pack salto was a little bit far away from the bar, but was able to keep it moving. We have an exhibition on vault. Amanda Hargraves just finished her vault as an exhibition performer for the Pioneers. Her score will not count toward the team total. I'm really impressed with Hannah Loy pushing through that bar routine to finish strong. for Iowa State. They have one more competitor in the lineup. And that will finish us up for vault. One more performer on bars and another four competitors, on balance beam. We have some exhibitions today. Denver with that 49.350 on vault. Their highest is a 49.425, sorry. So just really close to their high so far this season. Definitely above their average. Nice front toss to Scale on beam. And again on bars, Anna Irene Palacios, their final competitor on this event. A little bit of form separation there on the half turn, but nice Jaeger. A little short on the handstand and on the overshoot. Little slight deductions. Short on that handstand as well. We'll see what the judges do with that routine. It was a nice routine, but lots of little form breaks here and there. And that'll finish us up on bars. On beam is Lydia Webb from Southeast Missouri. Super strong routine so far. And a strong finish. That is a great beam routine. She was fifth up in the rotation for them. They'll have one more competitor that will count toward the team total, or at least can count. Each of the schools puts up six gymnasts. Five scores count. They can drop the lowest. Southeast Missouri team competing twice this weekend. Getting some last minute instruction from her coach. As I mentioned, we have a great crowd here in Magnus Arena for this competition. Both Iowa State and Denver in the Big 12 Conference. They have five teams this year. And they'll be losing Oklahoma, but adding some teams next year, University of Arizona, Arizona State, and Utah. It's a great matchup today of these Big 12 competitors, Iowa State and University of Denver. Again, this is Anna Speller, your sixth competitor on balance beam for Southeast Missouri. Nice front toss to that handspring. Little bit of hesitation between the moves. We'll see if the judges give her credit for that. And the gymnasts are required to do skills in combination to get to their 10-0 start value. A little bit shy on that second leap. Judges are really looking for 180-degree split on all of their leaps and jumps. Front toss to Scale, showing great control. Let's see if she can stick the dismount. Punch front full, slight hop on the landing. Now, the judges are actually taking off if they don't hold that finish position for at least 1 second. It's a new rule this year. We call it the college salute when you're kind of leaning forward or back and saluting to the judges. So they're definitely going to have a little bit of a deduction there besides the hop on that landing. We will have two exhibition competitors on beam, I believe, for Southeast Missouri. Southeast Missouri high score on beam so far this season is a 49.175. See the score for Iowa State on bars, the 48.650. Their high score so far this season has been a 49.250, and the average is a 49.050, so a little bit off of that here today. Up on beam is Janelle Lopez. Again, in exhibition, so her routine will not count toward the team total. Front toss into a back tuck. Again, a little bit of hesitation between those skills. It's important to keep your arms moving so the judges give you credit for the combination. Scissor split leap. Just a little bit tentative on that leap and had to lean forward. Just a little shy on those leaps for that 180 degree split. Nice full turn. Dismount here. That was a good solid performance. Just a little bit of mistakes here and there, but again, a great opportunity for her to get up in front of the judges and in front of a crowd like this here in Magnus Arena. A little bit of experience. And I believe we have one more competitor in exhibition. It'll be Ava Johnston. The University of Denver will have one more home meet this season on March 3rd against San Jose State, Lindenwood, and Air Force. And this will be our last opportunity to see Lindenwood. That program is being cut after this year, so definitely come if you're in Denver and can come to that meet on March 3rd at 2 p.m. here in Magnus Arena. After this week, the Pioneers will travel next week to West Virginia, and Iowa State will be there as well. And then they'll be at BYU before returning home. Again, this is Ava Johnston, exhibition performance for Southeast Missouri State. Nice left handspring layout, step out. Pitch kick to an aerial cartwheel into a beat jump. Really doing a good amount of difficulty in this routine, just lacking a little bit of the presentation we see from some of the other gymnasts. And this are dismount. And that was a good routine. She'll be happy with that performance. And that'll finish us up for this first rotation here in Magnus Arena. And when we come back, we'll move on to rotation number two. University of Denver will be on bars, Iowa State on beam, and Southeast Missouri State will be on floor. had a great rotation. Super happy with the finish on that. Then the highlights here from the bars. This is their first performer, Ella Schnell. Just really did a great job right on top of the bar on that giant full into the double tuck. Slight little movement, but great for them on bars. And on beam, some really good performances from Southeast Missouri State as well. I'm going to show Lydia Webb. Beautiful front toss into a scale. Nice leap series. And that was her combination, front aerial into back handspring swing down, and then a nice stuck landing on the dismount. And here in Magnus Arena today, the theme is My Reason, My Ribbon. Each one of the gymnasts for the Pioneers has come up with a cause that they're passionate about, and they're wearing ribbons in their hair for those causes. We've got the purple ribbon for Alzheimer and dementia. Ava Mabanta and Bella Mabanta are passionate about that. We've got the purple ribbon also for animal abuse awareness for Mia Heaving. The orange and purple ribbons are for cancer awareness and cancer survivors, Rosie Casale and Ashley Gallen. Gold ribbon is for childhood cancer, and that's Amanda Hargrave's passion. The dark green ribbon is for climate change, and that's Riley Mundell's passion. Orange ribbon is for diversity, equity, and inclusion, Mila Brush and Momo EY. The blue ribbon is for education awareness. A number of the gymnasts are wearing one for that. And foster care as well. And then the dark blue ribbon is for human trafficking. We've also got a rainbow ribbon for LGBTQ plus pride. Lime green ribbon for Lyme disease and mental health. There's a green ribbon for organ transplant donation and a gray ribbon for Parkinson's. So each of the gymnasts really passionate about raising awareness for causes they feel are really, really close to their heart. And you can see the lineup there on bars for Denver. Denver coming off of one of their best performances on bars last week. The high score was a 49.750. Just really let things off. Rosie Casale is going to get them started on floor for Southeast Missouri's Caitlin Hamilton. And on beam for Iowa State is Hannah Lohan. Team from Rosie Casale to start the rotation. Really been dialing in those landings. Details are super important. Over on beam, great series by Handspring Layout Step Out. The high score so far for Iowa State on beam this season is a 49.225. For Southeast Missouri is a 49.325. And a nice dismount on beam. Great routine to start them off on this rotation. You can see the excitement from Hannah Moyen, their leadoff competitor on the balance beam. Next up on bars will be Kylie Warwick. Kylie is an All-American in this event. Bar on the half turn. Great. Straddle Jaeger. Nice handstand. Really moving well in this bar routine so far. Right in the handstand. See if she can stick the landing on this layout double flyaway. little slight hop on the landing, but that was a great bar routine. Next up on beam for Iowa State will be Lauren Abrocha. Beck hands for two layout step outs right over the center of the beam. Really important that these gymnasts are aggressive on beam. More aggressive, the better you usually perform. Nice leap series. On floor is Jordan Napolitano, Southeast Missouri, and on bars is going to be Madison Ulrich. The freshman has really come out with a level of confidence I haven't seen out of a freshman in a really long time. Super important this season. Nice finish on floor. Next up on beam for Iowa State will be Noelle Adams. She is an amazing freshman this year, has been Big 12 newcomer of the week. Checks very, very slight, the finish of that. Nice scissor leap series. Next up on bars is going to be Mia Hebink. Mia is coming off of an amazing routine last week. She got a 9.975. She starts off her bars with a really unique release move. It's called a Rikna. Height on that, right into a pack salto when she's on. Score for Madison Ulrich is a 9.9. Getting me a heaving on bars. Stick a number of them in warm-ups. Yes, and a stuck landing. That's probably about as good as she did last week. Next up on floor is Sydney Crouch for Southeast Missouri State. And next up on beam for Iowa State will be Josie Bergstrom. was a really unfortunate fall on beam. Just looked like she was a little bit off in her dance. Over on bars is Jessica Hutchinson from the University of Denver. Beautiful. See if Jessica can stick this landing. And she does. Beautiful. I love the way she does that layout double flyaway. Just the position in the air, chest up on the landing. And Josie Bergstrom finishing up her beam. She had that really, really weird fall on her dance. So they'll definitely want to drop that score again. They count five scores of the six gymnasts that go up on each event. The last performer for University of Denver on bars, there will be an exhibition, is Riley Mundell. Riley is Big 12 bar champion. Has a gorgeous Takacha release move right off the beginning of her routine. Next up on beam for Iowa State will be Lauren Thomas. Will be Taylor Engel for Southeast Missouri State. Watch the beginning of this bar routine for Riley. Huge release move. Beautiful reverse hecht. Toe hand right on top of the bar. She is just such a consistent bar worker for this team. Let's see if she can stick this layout double flyaway. And she stuck it. That was gorgeous. I don't know what the judges are gonna take off from that. We'll have to see what they do score-wise, but that was a great routine for Riley. Pressure here on beam with that last gymnast falling. You said a 9-2 was her score. They definitely want to drop that. Nice 2.5 twist to punch front on floor. She was able to stay in bounds. I didn't see the line judge raise her flag, so won't be an extra 10th point deduction. We have one more performer on bars. It's an exhibition, Momo EY. After that fall, just really confident, exactly what they needed, that hit routine from Lauren Thomas. Job exhibition performance from Momo again. She's getting that experience. If they ever need to put her in the lineup, she's right there ready to go. Great routine. And that'll finish us up on bars for the University of Denver. Celebrated a little too soon on that back tuck. 1 to 1.5. Nice landing, a little bit of a bobble there in the middle, but another strong performance by Rachel Wilk on beam. That'll finish up their regular competitors in their 6-up, 5 count. We will have an exhibition by Logan Basil. Nice 2.5 twist on floor. Nice floor routine. Beautiful execution on those split jumps. So they're split into a split jump. Beginning of her routine. Again, this is exhibition. And a strong finish. And that'll finish us up on beam for Iowa State. We have 3 competitors to go on floor here for Southeast Missouri State. Above their average so far this season on bars. Not quite the highest they've gotten, but definitely above their average. Next up on floor for Southeast Missouri is Lydia Webb. Double tuck, great landing. Great leap series. And that's going to be a really strong score for them on floor. Definitely one of their strongest performers. We've seen a lot of 9.7 so far. I expect that to be definitely above a 9.8. You can see the score from Iowa State on beam of 48.7. It'll be their final on that event. Their season average is 48.825, so just below that. These mad Madison Green getting ready for her floor as the sixth competitor here for Southeast Missouri on floor. Madison is from Crestwood, Kentucky. She's a junior. This meet, and one of the keys she said is just really peaking at the right time and slow and steady throughout these meets. All these teams still have a lot of competition left to go this season, leading up into regionals in March and nationals in April. Bit of a disappointing finish for them on floor. They'll definitely want to drop that score. We will have one final competitor on this event in exhibition. Looks like actually we're not going to have an exhibition performance on floor, so we will close out this second rotation. And when we come back, the University of Denver will be on beam, ISU will be on floor, and Southeast Missouri State will be on vault. Hey, welcome back to Magnus Arena. Got some highlights from the last rotation. This is Mia Hebink, that Rikna, beautiful release move, and then really finished it off here with the stuck landing. Great job on that bar team. Really strong rotation for the University of Denver, just a little bit above their average of 49.45. And then over to beam. This is Lauren Thomas from Iowa State. Really confident. Beautiful 180 degree split on those leaps. And then the dismount. Little bit of form, but it's easier for us to see in slow motion, but sticks the landing. Great job. And then over on floor, this is Taylor. A nice 2.5 twist, nice controlled landing. And then 1.5 to a front layout. And we're getting set for the third rotation. And Iowa State will be on floor, University of Denver on beam. There's Coach Melissa Kutcher-Reinhart. She really has done so much with this Pioneer program, making it to the final four. We will see some new gymnasts in the lineup. And Bella Babanta will be back in the lineup. She injured her ankle in Oklahoma. She's really a star beam worker here for the University of Denver, and excited to see her back in the lineup. And on vault, our first competitor will be Taylor Engel. Nice rich ankle fold. She actually piked down, which made her take that big step backwards. She had great distance from the table, something the judges are really looking for. And over on beam, starting the pioneers out is Abby Thompson. Abby qualified for nationals last year, was able to go because she was injured. She starts off right here with a very difficult series, aerial cartwheel into back handspring. It was a little bit off, but her experience was able to really hold on to that landing. Is really where the pioneers are going to need to be aggressive on this event, show that confidence. Scissor split leap. A little overbend on that full turn, it'll be a slight deduction. So far, a good start for the pioneers on beam. This is her dismount. It's an aerial cartwheel into a 1.5 twist. Over on vault is Haley Kuhn. Slight little step on the landing for Abby, but a good start for the pioneers on beam. And that was a good vault by Allie Kuhn as well. Over on floor for Iowa State will be Emily Hong. Looks like we're having a conversation at the judges' table on floor, so we're just going to get started a little bit later. There may have been some lineup changes. Next up on beam for the University of Denver will be Momo EY. Momo is a Big 12 champion on beam. This Denver squad has a lot of difficulty in their routines on beam. We've seen a lot of triple series. Next up on vault for Southeast Missouri will be Jordan Napolitano. And we're getting started on floor again with Emily Hong. Momo mounting the beam. Momo's triple series. I can't swing my out, step out, yeah, step out. Right over the center of the beam. Nice high double tuck on floor. Just a slight hop for Momo on that dismount. I wish she could have stuck that landing, but it was a great routine. Nice job on those leaps at floor. And a strong start for Iowa State on floor. Next up on beam for Denver will be Rosie Casali. And on vault for Southeast Missouri State will be Lydia Webb. Rosie will be starting off with her triple series right here. And Nice job, Rosie. Just a slight step backwards on that backhand spring layout, step out. Be a small deduction. She's had some trouble on this leap series last meet, but great job today. And a stuck landing. Other than that little step backwards on her triple series, you can see the excitement for her finishing that routine strong. Next up on floor for Iowa State is going to be Paige Wills. Next up on vault for Southeast Missouri, coach talking to her right there, will be Janelle Lopez. Up on beam for the Pioneers will be freshman Madison Ulrich. A little bit of a miss on the first pass on floor. Supposed to do a jump out of that 1.5 twist, which is a little bit off. Final competitor on vault for Southeast Missouri State lead, Madison Green. Maddie Ulrich mounting the beam for Pioneers. Nice, the handspring layout, step out. Nice 1.5 twist into a layout, right in the middle of the floor. And strong floor for Iowa State, other than that first tumblings pass. Just a little bit off on that. Again, the final competitor on vault for Southeast Missouri State is Madison Green. Nice vault, great landing again. Starts out of a 9.9 start value. And here is Madison's dismount on beam. And the stuck landing. Great routine from Madison and the DU Pioneers on beam. Next up on floor for Iowa State will be Ella Schell. Hugs for Melissa Kutcher Reinhardt for Maddie. Great beam routine. Next up for on beam for University of Denver will be Jessica Hutchinson. Jessica has scored over 9.9 the last every meet but one this season. Start beam here again. Jessica Hutchinson, the senior in Pennsylvania. She has beautiful technique on this event. Front toss, back handspring. For Iowa State as well. A little little bit of arm movement on that full turn. The judges might take a slight deduction. Let's see if she can stick this landing. And holds on to it. Great job on beam for Jessica Hutchinson. Nice high double pike for Kaya, finishing out this floor team. That was a great routine for Iowa State on floor. And up on beam, Bella Mabanta. And I mentioned she hurt her ankle at Oklahoma a few weeks ago, and this is her first time back in competition. You can see the score for Jessica Hutchinson, a 9.95. Bella is a beautiful beam worker. See if she can stick this McCann spring layout. Step out, just a slight bobble. Typical leap series coming up. Really attacked that leap series. I love the amplitude she gets on her leaps and jumps. Again, coming back from that injury, and she was landing on that ankle that she had hurt before, just might be a little bit. But got right back up into the same series. This is really good experience for her. And dismount. So they'll definitely want to drop that score. But great for her to get back on the beam in that lineup. Next up on floor for Iowa State will be Hannah Loyn. See Melissa Kutcher-Reinhart giving Bella some instructions. Again, coming back from an injury, not being able to train for a couple weeks is really, really hard. But great job her getting back in the lineup and really going for it. We will have two exhibition performances on beam for the Pioneers, Mila Brush. And again, Hannah Loim for Iowa State on floor. She's their fifth performer on floor. Double layout, great landing. Very difficult first pass. One and a half into front layout, a little bit of form break in that one and a half, but great height. Finish on beam for Mila Brush in that exhibition position. And that was a strong routine for Iowa State. You can see the excitement finishing up that routine. So far has been a strong rotation for Iowa State on floor. Yeah, And the Pioneers will have one final competitor on beam, the Amanda Hargraves. Amanda's a freshman. Out of Woodinville, Washington. She competed for Metropolitan Gymnastics. Denver Pioneer squad has an over 3.5 cumulative GPA from this fall. Amazing athletes and students. Just a little crooked on that aerial walkover. Just looked a little bit tentative and cautious on that. Didn't quite get enough push out of her front leg. Up on floor, the final competitor for Iowa State is their awesome freshman, Noelle Adams. Noelle is out of Mesa, Arizona. And was Big 12 newcomer of the week. Punch front layout into a 1.5. On those leaps on floor. Nice double tuck, great landing. Great floor routine for Noelle Adams, again the freshman out of Mesa, Arizona, finishing up that rotation for Iowa State on floor. And that'll close us out for the third rotation. When we come back, we'll be moving on to our fourth and final rotation here in Magnus Arena. Turns out we have one final exhibition performance here on floor for Iowa State. Nice first pass. For Noelle Adams right before her was a 9.9 to finish out. Iowa State super strong on floor. So far, this is a great exhibition routine. And nice double pipe, just a little bit of over rotation. And that was a great routine. It'll be a great option for them to put into the lineup in the future. That was Rachel Wilk doing an exhibition performance for Iowa State. And we'll be back with the fourth and final rotation. Rotation. This is Jessica Hutchinson on beam. Scored a 9.95. Just beautiful. Watch the 180 degree split in those leaps. She has just great technique. And this dismount really nails the landing, really holds on. Again, it's super important for them to hold that landing. You can see really fighting for that. No movement. Great job on beam. And on vault, Madison Green, their final competitor. Beautiful vault. You can see she's a little bit crooked on the line, so the judges took a little bit off for that, but that was a beautiful vault and great finish for them on that event. And then Noelle Adams on floor. Such fun dance, great combination of dance and tumbling. Again, really promising career here at Iowa State. Nice high double tuck to finish. Chest up, exactly what the judges are looking for. Scored a 9.9 on that routine. And in this fourth and final rotation, right now the Pioneers are leading at 148.225. And then ISU has 146.575, and just behind them is Southeast Missouri State with a 146.425. This is a really close competition between those two schools. Denver almost a full 2 points ahead of Iowa State so far going into this fourth rotation. This is a really strong event for the Pioneers and a strong event for Iowa State as well. Season high for the Pioneers on floor is a 49.475. Their average is a 49.315. Iowa State for vault, their high is a 49.350. And their average is a 49.1. And Southeast Missouri on bars, their average is a 48.675. But they've actually gotten a 49.35. So this could be really close between Iowa State and Southeast Missouri if each one of them has a really great rotation. And our first competitor for Iowa State on vault will be Paige Wills. On Southeast Missouri on bars is Ava Johnson, getting started now. And on floor will be Kylie Rorick for Pioneers. Nice start for Iowa State on vault, just a pop on that landing. So far, bars going well. Really short on that handstand, so that'll be a pretty significant deduction. But a great landing on the dismount. So little deductions on that bar routine. We definitely won't see the 9.8 plus, but a good start for them on this rotation. Waiting for the floor judges. Next up on vault for Iowa State will be Hannah Loim. And on bars for Southeast Missouri will be Taylor Engel. Second vault. A nice Yurchenko full, pretty big hop on the landing, but she got great height. I love her position in the air. Off the table. First score for Iowa State on vault at 9.775. And here starts Kylie Rorick on floor. Kylie is a sophomore out of Charlotte, North Carolina. Nice high straddle Jaeger on bars. Is Noel Adams, another Yurchenko full, and a good strong finish from Southeast Missouri State on bars. This Denver team really looks super strong. Double pike, been very impressed with their fitness this season. They just make it through these floor routines very easy, and it's all credit to their strength and conditioning coach. Great job there. Kylie Rorick on floor, beautiful start for the Pioneers on that event. Next up on vault for Iowa State will be Josie Bernstrom. Kaylin Hamilton will be next up on bars for Southeast Missouri. Another Yurchenko full. That was gorgeous. Really stuck the landing. Was a little bit crooked, but those lines are there really to guide the judges. But that was a great ball to get starts out of a 9-9 start value, so not out of a 10. Kaylin Hamilton getting ready to go on bars. Next up on floor for Denver will be Momo EY. Beautiful laid out Ganger on bars. Oh, it was one of the best I've seen in college gymnastics. Really short on that handstand before her giant swings. Lots of difficulty in that routine. If they can just get her to hit those handstands, that is going to score big for Southeast Missouri on bars. Next up on vault is Kaya Parker, and up on floor is Momo EY. Nice first combination pass. Step on bars for Southeast Missouri will be Lydia Webb. And the final competitor on vault for Iowa State will be Emily Hong. Scoot back on that last pass for Momo. That will be a slight deduction. Strong routine for them. Again, a little bit of a deduction there on that last pass, but that was a great floor routine. On vault, Emily Hong for Iowa State. On bars, Lydia Webb. Beautiful Yurchenko 1.5 on vault. Just a big hop on the landing, but that is a great vault. When she sticks that, it's going to score big. Nice handstand on bars. giant full into a double flyaway. Little step on the landing, but all in all, great routine for Southeast Missouri from Lydia Webb. And that will finish us up at Iowa State on vault. Next up on four for the University of Denver will be Madison Rittenbach. Waiting for the final score. There's the final score for Emily Hong on vault. So Iowa State will end up with a 49.150. Madison Rittenbach on floor for DU, and Janelle Lopez will be going on bars for Southeast Missouri. We put the half into a 1.5 twist, a little bit crooked on the takeoff. He's able to pull that around. And they've had some injuries, so they've had to put some gymnasts in they wouldn't typically have in their lineup. Not season-ending injuries, ones where those gymnasts will come back. But this is a great opportunity for a freshman like Maddie to really step up. He's able to stay in bounds. Bars is Janelle Lopez. Nice strong finish for the Pioneers on floor. Good release move on bars. A little short on that handstand. And short on that one as well. Really need to work on getting those handstands right up on the top of the bar. It's an easy deduction to eliminate, and a little step on the landing, but I'm really impressed with this Southeast Missouri team on bars. We have one more performer to go after her. It'll be Sydney Crouch. And next up on four for the Pioneers will be senior Rosie Casali. Rosie is out of Weddington, North Carolina from Southeastern Gymnastics. Can't see it enough. Rosie has really worked hard to get her fitness and just the confidence this season I've seen from her on all of her events. Has had some amazing all-around scores as well. He has a really fun routine. Nice 1.5 into a layout. Again, Sydney Crouch on bars for Southeast Missouri, their final competitor. Short on the handstand. Nice dismount. Strong finish for Southeast Missouri on bars. And that'll finish up bars for us. We have his floor. Rosie's final tumbling pass. It's a 2.5 twist into a punch front. Nice finish. All about timing. Great floor routine for Rosie. I'm just waiting for Sydney Crouch's score on bars. so far on floor. The Pioneers are doing really well. All above 9.8. Next up is freshman Madison Ulrich. Madison is out of Fort Mill, South Carolina. Also went to Southeastern Gymnastics. Teammate of Kylie and Rosie's. Madison really just seems super comfortable here in college gymnastics. There's often an adjustment coming from elite or JO gymnastics. The crowds are very, very different. You don't compete weekend after weekend. She has done such a great job really showing that confidence. Something else that's so different about college gymnastics too is many of these gymnasts were homeschooled or didn't go to school full days when they were competing for JO or Elite, and now they're having to go to school and do gymnastics. Beautiful open double tuck. She's working on a double layout. Hopefully we'll see that in her routine sometime later this year or next year. Score for Rosie Casale is a 9.9. Beautiful leaps. One and a half. Beautiful. Love the flexibility out of that. Final cash is a double pike. Beautiful landing. That was the best routine I think I've seen her do so far this season. Really controlled on both of those landings on her double tuck and double pike. Career high on floor is at 9.925. Let's see what the judges do with that score this time. And our final competitor of the 6-up-5 count is Jessica Hutchinson for the Pioneers. We will have one exhibition performance after Jessica goes. Jessica's capable of a 10. She has received a 10 in her career on this floor routine. Not on this floor routine, but on her floor routine last year, which was actually her a routine that was a dedication to her mom. Jessica Hutchinson. Double twist, great landing. Score for Madison Ulrich is a 9.925, so tying her career best. Beautiful leaps. Watch the technique on this one and a half twist into a front layout. Just in such control, makes it look super easy. This is a perfect routine. One last pass left. 1.5 twist into a straddle jump. Great control. Beautiful way to finish out this meet for her. She has had a great competition today. We'll see what the judges do with that score. We will have one more performance on floor for the Pioneers. An exhibition will be Neela Brush. Jessica's a senior. She's planning on being a nurse when she finishes up college. Really impressed with all of these Pioneers and their areas of interest. Riley Mundell did an internship with NASA this past summer. She's a physics major, has already gotten a grant for some research that she's done. Her family also has businesses, and it's a 10 for Jessica Hutchinson on floor. Very well deserved, beautiful floor routine. Her first one this season on floor. You can see how happy all of the other gymnasts are for her. It's so amazing. College gymnastics is all about the team. It is such a great experience for these gymnasts that have competed individually for so long to be a part of a group that really, truly cares about each other. You can see Abby crying there. I mean, just absolutely amazing. Julie Campbell, their person responsible for keeping them healthy. What a great way to do it here at home, too. And we do have one more competitor. Neela Brush on floor. Again, exhibition performance. To a double tuck. Little short on that second jump full turn. Again, that's why she's in this exhibition spot, getting that experience. If the camera can catch it, but every single team came over to watch this final floor. Double pike, great job, and they're all cheering for her. I absolutely love the camaraderie here in the gym. Great finish for Neela on floor. Great way to finish her competition today. And it's just so amazing to see all these gymnasts out supporting each other regardless of their team. Absolutely love it. When we come back, we'll have some final scores and some highlights. And welcome back to Magnus Arena. This beautiful 10.0 routine from Jessica Hutchinson on floor. She very well deserved. She is just so beautiful, such an amazing gymnast to watch. Really watch this impeccable technique on all of her tumbling. Just makes it look easy, great height, drops out of the sky on those landings. Again, watch these leaps, 180 degree split, no deductions at all. So exciting for her to do that here at home. Got 10-0, her first one this season. team super excited for her. And the final results on vault, we've got Jessica Hutchinson, first place with a 9.975. Absolutely wonderful, great vault. Lots of competitors here between DU and Iowa State, and then Madison Green hopping in there in that multiple tie for third with a 9.85. We've got uneven bars, Mia Hebink with a 9.925 and a tie for second. Three-way tie, Madison, Jessica, and Riley. Great routines overall on uneven bars as well. Balance beam, Jessica, that 9.95. Two-way tie for second 9.9 with Momo and Rosie. Great routines. Floor, Jessica Hutchinson with the 10. Madison Ulrich, the freshman, 9.925. Rosie Casale and Noelle Adams with a 9.9 for third place. And all around, this will be Jessica Hutchinson's career high, 39.825. She's going to move up in the standings for sure in the all-around in the nation. Madison, second place, 39.550. That may be a career high for her as well. Actually, it ties her career high, and Rosie Casale with a 39.375 as well. Just absolutely great job by these gymnasts today at DU. And that'll do it for us here at, it'll do it for us here in the Magnus Arena at Campus of University of Denver. I'm Marcy Jenkins. Thank you for joining us, and join us again on March 3rd when the Pioneers take on some other great competitors for senior night here in Magnus Arena.
To the left. Take it back now, y'all. Two hops this time. Two hops this time. Right foot.
Thank you for participating in the Denver Gymnastics tradition of the Cha-Cha Slide presented by 505 Southwestern. All right, fans, it's time for today's final scores. First, we will have the scores for Vault, presenting the Vault Awards as Senior Vice Chancellor Mark DiLorenzo. There was a six-way tie for third place on Vault today. For the six-way tie for third place, from Southeast Missouri State with a 9.85, Madison Green. Also 9.85 from Iowa State by Emily Hong. From Iowa State as well with a 9.85, Noelle Adams. Tied for third with 9.85 from the Denver Pioneers, Riley Mundell. Also from the Denver Pioneers with a 9.85, Madison Ulrich. And 9.85 from the Denver Pioneers for Mila Brush. In second place with a score of 9.875 from Iowa State, Josie Bergstrom. And and in first place on vault with a score of 9.975 from the Denver Pioneers, Jessica Hutchinson. Let's recognize one more time today's top finishers on vault. Now for the bars final scores, presenting the awards for bars is Elizabeth Bullock. There was a three-way tie for second place with a score of 9.9 from the University of Denver, Riley Mundell. Also finishing in a tie for second place with Riley Mundell with a score of 9.9 from the Denver Pioneers, Jessica Hutchinson. And with 9.9 as well from the University of Denver, Madison Ulrich. And now to recognize today's top finisher on bars with a score of 9.925 from the Denver Pioneers, Mia Hebing. Once again, let's recognize today's top finishers on bars. Now we have the scores for Beam. Presenting the awards for Beam is Professor Heather Martin. On Beam, a two-way tie for second place. In second place with a score of 9.9 from the Denver Pioneers, Rosie Casale. Also in a tie for second place with a score of 9.9 from the University of Denver, Bomoko Iwai. And today's top finisher on Beam with a score of 9.95 from the Denver Pioneers, Jessica Hutchinson. One more time, let's give it up for today's top finishers on Beam. And now we have the scores for Floor. Presenting the awards for Floor is Dean Fritz Mayer. There was a two-way tie for third place with 9.9 from Iowa State, Noel Adams. Also with a score of 9.9 from the Denver Pioneers, Rosie Casale. In second, a score of 9.925 from the University of Denver, Madison Ulrich. And today's top finisher on Floor, a perfect score of 10.0 from the Denver Pioneers, Jessica Hutchinson. One more time, let's recognize today's top finishers on Floor. And now we have the all-around scores. Presenting the awards for the all-around is Mark DiLorenzo. In third place, an all-around total of 39.375 from the Denver Pioneers, Rosie Casale. In second, with an all-around score of 39.550 from Denver, Madison Ulrich. Today's top all-around score ties a University of Denver program record, 39.825 from your Denver Pioneers, Jessica Hutchinson. Keep the applause going for today's top all-around finishers. And following today's final tally, we have our final team scores. In third place, a team score of 194.675, the Southeast Missouri State Redhawks. Second place, 195.800, the Iowa State Cyclones. And today's top team, a score of 197.775. Make some noise for your